Hola mi raza, welcome to my channel. Me llamo Andrés Enrique and bienvenidos a mi canal, guys. Buenos días mi raza. Bueno, I'm just getting up right now, heading to work right now. And the reason why I feel like I'm doing this video is because of everything that it's happening at the moment with COVID-19. I mean, it's very affecting a lot of people, and it's also affecting me, guys. You know, the reason why I say it's affecting me is because today, this morning, I woke up at 3 a.m. this morning. I don't know why. And I was just like thinking about the whole situation with COVID-19 and how it's affecting everyone. And honestly, guys, it is messing up my mental mind, my mental health, just because of the fact that, you know, just watching the news, you know, they keep on talking about the situation, and I feel like it's getting everyone scared. And without knowledge, of course we don't know what's going on, and not having all the resources, not being doctors, just listening to the news are always going to scare us. You know, they want to scare us. Of course we have to take precautions. Of course we have to, you know, we have to take care of ourselves like every other day. You know, we take care of ourselves every single day, guys. You know, and right now, I don't know why. Now it's just like, I don't know. Just by looking at these streets, guys, like, I'm not from this area, but the roads are empty, guys. They are completely empty, and I know a lot of people are being very careful, very cautious with their, you know, with the coronavirus, and it's affecting me. Today's my sister's birthday, guys. I want to send a shout out to my sister, Mary. Happy birthday, sister. I love you so much. Hopefully I can upload this video today. That way you guys can see what my work experience is, especially dealing with this COVID-19 situation. I am gonna take you guys on my work experience today, because we have an outing with our youth. I mean, not our youth, with our clients with developmental disabilities. So yeah, guys, I am gonna take you on this adventure with me, and hopefully you guys enjoy. That way you guys can see what we have to deal with, especially with COVID-19. I'm really scared to go to the zoo. I don't know why I'm freaking scared to go to the zoo. We're going to the zoo. So yeah, guys, and just follow me on this day. That way you guys can see what the coronavirus is, you know, how it's affecting everyone. And guys, so I just got here to work, and I just received a text message from my friend saying that his store is closed for 2 weeks due to the coronavirus. So this is ridiculous. No worries, mia. No, es que me le digo que me acaba de mandar mensaje mi amigo. So here's the thing that I've learned about COVID-19. I mean, it's airborne. Common sense. I remember when I used to work for Maricopa County Public Health. The CDC will always get involved in every situation like this. When it came to, I remember back then in 2014 when I used to work for Maricopa County, we dealt with Ebola. You know, it was nationwide. COVID-19, of course, is something like this. It's a very serious matter because it's the spread of, you know, a virus that can be deadly to the elderly. which is for everyone. You know, but they're high risk because of their immune system and because of their health conditions. Whoever has lung problems, breathing problems, you know, those type of. We have to understand, and we have to keep ourselves calm, because honestly, just by looking at the news and everything that is going on TV, it just scares everyone. And I think that we have to remain calm, especially for our kids. Mucha gente no tiene que realizar que esta situación la hacemos peor y nos asustamos nosotros mismos. So tenemos que aprender de controlarnos al momento de estas acciones. Especialmente porque tenemos hijos, tenemos familias y tenemos amigos. COVID-19, como les digo, es una situación que es really, really scary. Y tenemos que aprender de tratar de controlarnos. But, como pueden ver, estoy en el trabajo. So, vamos a llevar a nuestros members to the Phoenix Zoo. So, let's see if the Phoenix Zoo is open. We really don't want to do anything with them, but we cannot change their schedule because a lot of them do have behaviors and we need to prevent from that happening. But we did get permissions from their parents. As long as they give us a consent that we can still take him, then it's okay. But if the Phoenix Zoo, because I have to call right now at 9 a.m. to confirm that they're open, si están abiertos, vamos a ir, porque no les podemos cambiar el schedule a nuestros miembros, especialmente porque ellos tienen muchos behaviors severos, so no podemos cambiar their schedule. We have to go by their set day. So I'll keep you guys posted. Let's see if we end up going to the Phoenix Zoo, and I am gonna take you guys out too, so you guys can see how it looks, because honestly, it looks like a ghost town. Phoenix looks like a ghost town. So I just got done talking to my supervisor, and then we just got a call that another of our members is not coming in because their group home is closing them down. It is, especially because, are we gonna get shut down too? Wow. See guys, this is the thing that I'm like worried about, that the news always have to give us information. The health officials warning US is at tipping point. I don't know. I mean, this coronavirus, it's really serious matter, and just being at work, it just makes me want to just go home. I really don't feel safe knowing that the news is, you know, putting this in their, you know, website. So I don't know. This is honestly one of the days that when you read things in the news, you start worrying more and more because, you know, the situation. And just, you know, I always listen to 101.5, and they're always keeping us updated regarding any news. I just hope that this thing ends, because it does worry me, not only for myself, but for my family, for friends, families, our patients, you know, the youth that I work for. Yesterday, I couldn't work with my youth because, you know, grandma didn't feel safe. Hopefully, my youth that I see today after this job, you know, doesn't cancel. So we'll see how this goes, because this corona got everyone messed up. So, yeah. So we'll see what happens. We're just waiting for an email from the health, not the health department, from DDD to send us information if all programs are closed due to the coronavirus. We haven't gotten no information yet, so we're just, you know, checking our emails every 5 minutes to make sure that, you know, we want to keep our patient, you know, our clients safe, you know, healthy. And I think right now with the situation, I feel that every department is closing. You know, like my friend's office closed because of the coronavirus. So everyone is just messaging me, letting me know if we're open. You know, it just sucks because a lot of stores are going to be open. And today's my sister's birthday. I love you, sister. Hopefully I can find you a little cake.
Uno, dos, tres. Oh. For the most up-to-date information or to find answers to frequently asked questions,
transferring you to the Phoenix Zoo.
914.
Thank you for calling the Phoenix Zoo.
Guys, so the Phoenix Zoo is actually open and it's packed. Mia, ¿qué piensas? ¿Está lleno?
Yes, coronavirus.
It's crazy because we thought that it was going to be empty, pero está bien lleno. So guys, we ended our day here at the zoo. It was pretty packed. I was really surprised. I thought it was going to be affecting a lot of families, but not really. We hope that it was going to be only our members and probably other schools, but I got a lot of parents took advantage of this day, I guess. Hey guys, oh my god, my shirt makes me look so fat. But guys, I just got done dropping off one of my members from my work because, but the problem is that driving to drop off my members from my first job, I get a call from one of my youth's parent, one of their guardians. Calling me that she's canceling services because no se siente muy muy cómoda de tener a su hijo en centros públicos.
Mom's favorite flower, the Alcatraz. Mom, ¿estás haciendo tortillas?
So, okay, today we're gonna talk about the coronavirus.
To you, happy birthday, dear. Happy birthday to you.
Bueno, mi raza, aquí me despido con este video que, honestly, guys, I wasn't thinking of actually doing a video today, pero el motivo que hice este video es porque anoche no pude dormir y me quedé pensando con toda esta situación de coronavirus, the things that can happen to the world, especially, I mean, they're already happening, Italy's shut down, New York City is at risk of being shut down, my supervisor is always updating me of the things that are occurring because, I really don't like watching the news. Como le digo, me preocupo mucho pensando en esas cosas. Pero, mi gente, muchas gracias y demás. Felicitar el, happy birthday to my sister. Today is her birthday, and I just want to wish you a happy birthday. God bless you, sister. I love you so, so, so much. Fuck the drama. Fuck the bullshit. I will always have your back, no matter what. And the reason why I say this is because I love you so much, and ya sabes. But anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for following my channel, for the subscribers, los suscriptores que están haciendo follow me through this journey. Gracias, se los agradezco mucho. And new people, the new followers, whoever's watching this video, whoever it's, getting the opportunity to know me, muchas gracias y bienvenidos a mi canal. Y pues mi raza, ahí me despido y ya los guacho. Bye, mi raza.